Hi folks, Artistmac here. Today, celebrating the big 6-0. Yes, I've turned 60 years old. Ay-yi-yi. Well, I mean it can either be a tragic milestone or just another day in the park, depending on how you look at it. Me, I'm looking at it as just another day. I don't feel any different than I did yesterday when I was 59. I really don't feel any different physically than I did when I was 20. You know, I can still run up a flight of stairs two at a time. You know, no aches and pains and all that kind of stuff. Not even in the foot that I broke 9 years ago. I feel great. You know, I don't know how you're supposed to feel on that score. So I'm just gonna run with this and hope I hold up. Mentally, well, I probably lost a few brain cells, but then I didn't have that many to begin with, so who would know? But I'll tell you one thing. I definitely intend to look for every 60 and over discount that I'm entitled to. It took a long time to get here. A lot of people I know did not make it here or did not make it in the physical and mental shape they were hoping to. I guess one advantage of being 60 is, you know, especially in Chicago, is knowing what Chicago was like, we'll say in the 60s and 70s before all of this craziness we've got now started happening. I mean, Chicago's neighborhoods, even the poor ones, were not like this. I mean, you didn't have, you know, Leeds at Leeds stories every single day. I mean, there were not reports of, you know, every weekend, you know, after every weekend, you know, so many shots, so many wounded. It just was not like this. And there was no prohibition against gun ownership. I mean, people raised their kids right. What else can I say? I mean, I know mine certainly raised me right. You know, when they couldn't be around, I had a whole village out that front door. Ma'am, I'm sorry to call you at work, but your son is out on that sledding hill, and I know you said he wasn't supposed to be out there. He what? I'll murder him when I get home. And Mom did. And I learned. And I wonder how many parents are that strict today. Or if they're just, you know, oh well, I just want to be my child's friend. You know, I don't want him to hate me. There were times when, you know, I wanted to run away and be an adult and be my own man. But seeing what's going on today, I mean, it just points out the wisdom of what they did. And basically, they knew where I was and what I was doing from the day I was born until the day I left for college. I mean, they knew that school let out at 3. It was a 15-minute walk home. If they did not get a call from me by, we'll say, 20 after 3. Lucy, I had some splaining to do. Same in high school. It was a 45-minute ride there and back. High school let out at 3:30. If they did not get a call from me by 4:20, and this was before cell phones, so you couldn't fake where you were. I mean, if they got a call from me and I said I was home and there was crowd noise, like I might have been at the mall, again, trouble. But enough of my reminiscing. I have that kind of institutional memory, you know, experience. But at the same time, I can roll up my sleeves and get to work. So that's an advantage. I'll tell you, as I get older, I'm getting a lot more, we'll say, cynical. I've heard so many sob stories about everything under the sun. And after a certain point, there's just kind of sob story fatigue, I've gotten to the point where if I'm shown the most beautiful thing on God's green earth, I'm looking behind it to see how it's constructed, what's holding it up. I have a tendency to look gift horses in the mouth. And more often than not, I find that not only are their teeth bad, sometimes they don't even have any teeth. So that's a good thing. I am much less patient with salesmen, especially pushy salesmen, than I used to be. I am much more willing to argue with them, if what you are selling is such a fantastic deal, why aren't people knocking down your doors to get them? Why are you robocalling me and knocking on my door? Especially these energy companies, you get a knock on the door and a complete stranger wants to see your gas and electric bills. No, that's my personal financial information. They will not see it. And I have sent some of these people away totally frustrated, because I guess they're expecting that, because there's a lot of seniors over here, I guess I would be included now, that, we're all, well, he was such a nice young man, and he said that he would help me save money. No. Uh-uh. I will argue with you if you are a salesman until you are a puddle on the floor. If you were expecting that I was just going to roll over and, sign something, do something that was, going to affect me financially, no way. Let's see, what else? Well, one thing you find that your brain is like an attic, and, for everything that you put up there, something else has to leave. I've just about given up trying to keep up with, new models of cars, new models of cell phones, new movie and TV stars. They all pretty much look like Abercrombie and Fitch models to me. All interchangeable. Telly Savalas's, James Garner's, Mike Connors, Bill Conrad's, and don't get me started on these cartoons. SpongeBob?
You can't hold a candle to Bugs Bunny.
All right, anyway. I know, bad Bugs Bunny imitation, but that's the kind of cartoons that I grew up with. I just can't get into these new ones.
I gotta hand it to you, Fred.
They had voices then. Let's see, what else about 60? I guess that's about it. Everybody, who has gotten to 60 before me, except for my parents, talked about how traumatic it was. I think that's one reason I'm not freaking out about it, is because my parents didn't freak out about it. When my mom turned 60, she looked 45. When my dad turned 60, he could still, pretty much do everything that he did when he was 50 and 40. There was no decline at that point. There was physical decline afterwards. Mom lived to be 86, Dad lived to be 93, 94. Anyway, they lived good long lives, so if I don't do anything stupid, I can expect to live at least that long. So I'm just going to take, you know, whatever time I have left and use it wisely and judiciously, you know, especially people who, you know, just kind of want to drag their feet, and, you know, I'm just not going to suffer them gladly anymore. And, you know, now I have the excuse. Don't tell me that. I'm 60 years old. Whatever you've done, I've already done. And I know how it's supposed to be done. So, but let's see. What else? Like I say, a lot of things have changed in Chicago over the years. I'll tell you one thing that has not changed, at least since 1962.
Expressway noise!
It's right over there. Oh, another good thing about 60. Having lived over half my life without cable, I still don't miss it, even after 3 years.